हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस हैव द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ ट्रिग्नोमेट्री। इन दिस पार्ट वी विल बी स्टडिंग रिलेशंस अमंग ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक रेशियोज एंड ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक रेशियोज ऑफ पर्टिकुलर एंगल्स। लेट अस हैव अ लुक इन ट्राइंगल PMN। हियर एंगल M इज 90 डिग्री, एंगल N इज थीटा, सो एंगल P हैज़ टू बी 90 माइनस थीटा। सी, वी ऑल नो addition of all three angles of a triangle is 180 degree. So if we will add 90 plus theta and that we will be subtracting from 180, we will be getting answer 180 minus 90 minus theta. So the third angle of the triangle has to be 90 minus theta. So next, in first part we have studied the definitions of sine theta, cos theta and tan theta. So for angle theta, sine theta is equal to PM upon PN, because opposite side of angle N is PM and hypotenuse is PN. Same way, cos theta is equal to NM upon PN, because adjacent side of angle theta, that is angle N, is NM. Tan theta, opposite side upon hypotenuse, for angle theta, opposite side is PM and adjacent side is NM. So the ratio comes to PM upon NM. Now same as these three ratios, we can have all three trigonometric ratios for angle 90 minus theta. That is for angle P. So sine 90 minus theta is equal to opposite side upon hypotenuse. Opposite side of angle P is NM and hypotenuse is PN. So the ratio sine 90 minus theta will give you NM upon PN. Same way, cos 90 minus theta, adjacent side upon hypotenuse, will be PM upon PN. And tan 90 minus theta will be opposite side upon adjacent side, will give you NM upon PM. Further, you will have to see, students, that if we are having a look of equation 1 and equation 5, you will find that sine theta and cos 90 minus theta value is same. So we can surely say for any particular triangle, sine theta is equal to cos 90 minus theta. Same way, cos theta is equal to sine 90 minus theta. So this sine theta is equal to cos 90 minus theta and cos theta is equal to sine 90 minus theta. These are called complementary ratios. Complementary word before also we have studied. Complementary angles. What do they mean? They mean that addition of that two particular angles will be 90 degree. If we add theta and 90 minus theta, it will be addition 90. So sine theta and cos 90 minus theta are called complementary ratios. Same way, cos theta and sine 90 minus theta are complementary ratios. Also, you people have to note equation number 3 and equation number 6. If you concentrate, you will find they are inverse of each other. So PM upon NM into NM upon PM will give you 1. So here we can say that tan theta and tan 90 minus theta are complementary ratios. This is a special type of right angle triangle, 30, 60, 90 type. 30 and 60 are complementary angles. So for this, there are two special properties we will have to study. That side opposite to 30 degree is half of hypotenuse and side opposite to 60 degree is root 3 by 2 of hypotenuse. Here particularly you will see PQ. PQ is the side opposite to 30 degree is equal to half into PR. PR is hypotenuse. And QR is the side opposite to 60 degree will give you root 3 by 2 of PR, that is hypotenuse. As in the figure you can see, the sides are denoted by A, 2A and root 3A. If we substitute, we will be getting PR, that is hypotenuse 2A, and QR is equal to root 3A. PQ is assumed at A, so PR will be 2A and QR will be root 3A. Please note that in the particular 30-60-90, the property is side opposite to 30 degree is half of hypotenuse and side opposite to 60 degree is root 3 by 2 of hypotenuse. You can have a look of 30 degree angle values and 60 degree angle values referring the same figure. Sin 30 PQ upon PR, opposite side upon hypotenuse, will give you A upon 2A is equal to half. Cos 30 QR upon PR root 3A upon 2A, that will give you cancelling A, will give you root 3 by 2. Same way, tan 30 PQ upon QR is equal to A upon root 3A, that is opposite side upon adjacent side, will give you 1 by root 3. If you look at these all values for any particular 30 degree angle, they are not going to change. Same way, we will be seeing 60 degree angle ratios, sin 60, QR upon PR, root 3A upon 2A will give you root 3 by 2. Same way, cos 60 is half, tan 60 is root 3. As previously we have seen that complementary ratios, sin theta is equal to cos 90 minus theta, that also we can prove here. If you observe clearly, sin 30 value is half and cos 60 value is also half. So sin theta will give you cos 90 minus theta. Here theta value is 30, so we can have sin 30 is equal to cos 90 minus 30 will be cos 60. As we have proved, sin 30 value and cos 60 value has come same. Next special type of right angle triangle is 45-45-90. If you observe triangle ABC, angle A and angle C both are 45-45. So 90 plus 45 plus 45 will give you 180. Again, sides are denoted by A and root 2A. Here, the side opposite to 45 degree is 1 by root 2 of its hypotenuse. This is the special property again given for 45 degree. Here you can observe with the help of trigonometric ratios, the values are confirmed. Sin 45 opposite upon hypotenuse, AB upon AC is equal to 1 by root 2. Cos 45 adjacent upon hypotenuse will also be 1 by root 2. How this has happened? Because two angles are 45, so side opposite to them are also congruent. So this 45-45-90 triangle is an isosceles right angled triangle. So its sin 45 and cos 45 value has come same, because for any particular 45 degree, opposite side and adjacent side will be same. So both value has come 1 by root 2. Now let us have a look in tan 45 value. Tan 45 degree will be opposite side upon hypotenuse. As I said, both the values are same. So A upon A will give you 1. So this table will give you all the values together. If we have to denote, sin 0 will give you 0, if you want sine 45 value will be this way, you can observe. So all these values you will have to recollect always when you are solving different types of sums. Let us have a look in question number 1. Among that one question I have choose here, cos theta value is given 35 upon 37. Adjacent side upon hypotenuse. So if we make a triangle, adjacent side value we know and hypotenuse value we know, but that values we can substitute in one particular identity, that is sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. This identity is also depend upon Pythagoras theorem. If we have a right angle triangle and we name theta, adjacent side is given 35 and hypotenuse is given 37. But as the values are in ratio, we cannot have directly that way. So we have to accompany that with the constant k. With the help of this, we can have Pythagoras theorem and get the value for the third. Even with this method, we can have the third side and have remaining ratios. So here this is a special type of identity that is called as trigonometric identity. If we substitute here, you can observe the relation between tan theta, sin theta and cos theta. Tan theta is equal to sin theta upon cos theta. So values here which we have got, 12 upon 37 for sin theta upon 35 upon 37 for cos theta, which is given 12 upon 37 divided by 35 upon 37, divide opposite, multiply. So 12 upon 37 into 37 upon 35. This way we can have the operation, 37 will get cancelled and the answer will be 12 upon 35. So tan theta is equal to sin theta upon cos theta, also you can use in such type of sums. The next example, tan theta value is given 21 upon 20. As we know, tan theta is equal to sin theta upon cos theta. So sin theta will be 21k, cos theta is equal to 20k. In previous clip I have explained why k constant is needed. So as we know, there is one identity, sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. We can substitute the values and have the answer for k. K answer here we are getting 1 upon 29. Sin theta is given 21k, so 21 into 1 upon 29 is equal to 21 upon 29, and cos theta value will be 20 upon 29. The same example you can solve by making a right angle triangle also. Next, all three questions which are shown in this clip are depend upon values. We already have discussed all the values of 0, 30, 45, 60 and 90 degree. So that values directly you have to use in such type of sums. First question, 5 sin 30 plus 3 tan 45. So 5 as it is into sin 30 value half plus 3 into tan 45 value 1. 5 into half will be 5 upon 2, 3 into 1, 3. We can solve these fraction sums which will give you answer 11 by 20. Same way the next question, 4 upon 5 tan square 60 plus 3 sin square 60. Here square, you have to make the square of particular value. So sin 60 value is root 3 and square of that. sin 60 value is root 3 by 2 and square of that you will have to make. So the fractions 12 upon 5 plus 9 upon 4, making the denominators of the fraction equal, you can have the answer for this particular question is 93 upon 20. The third example is, again you have to substitute the values for sin 30, cos 0 and sin 90. It's a simple type of questions. 2 into half will give you 1 plus 1 plus 3 into 1. Multiplications we do first and then add remaining values. So answer of this question is 5. These all questions will help you to solve the full lesson of trigonometry. Thank you.